a cap that produces an electrical current, and bam, you're a creative genius who can always focus and is never sad. It seems like science fiction, yet scientists are exploring a real-life thinking cap. Hey Brainiacs, Julia here for DNews. Thinking caps are an old idea. Some type of electric charge delivered to the brain to increase performance has been around for nearly two centuries, yet it doesn't have the best reputation. Electroshock therapy recalls images of institutional torture during the mid-20th century for mental health patients, but in recent decades, the technique has been refined and made humane. It's proved very effective for even the worst cases of clinical depression and certain conditions with seizures. But that's not the only type of brain stimulation used today. Transcranial direct current stimulation is similar to electroconvulsive therapy. It uses non-invasive electrodes placed on the scalp to send a small electric charge to stimulate specific parts of the brain, but it uses 1/400th of the charge used in ECT. Some studies show that depending on the type of charge, positive or negative, it can reduce concentrations of inhibitory neurotransmitters or reduce types of transmitters that excite connections between neurons. Some studies, like one published in the Journal of American Medical Association Psychiatry, found that it's as effective as Zoloft in treating some cases of depression, and several studies have explored for its use as a treatment for ADHD. Yet a recent study says that TDCS might not live up to the hype. One study published in the journal Behavior Brain Research found that it doesn't deliver on supercharging smarts. The researchers tested 40 participants using a type of intelligence test before and after treatment with TDCS. The researchers figured IQ would increase after the procedure, partly because of familiarity with the test, but their scores would increase more than a control group's. But they found some surprising results. The group who received the treatment did worse in one area of test that measures logic and problem solving. The researchers cautioned that not a lot is known about this technique, and we don't know what the long-term effects are. Maybe supercharging one part of the brain could damage another. They also stressed that, well, more research is needed. The American military is interested in another technique that's a little more invasive. Deep brain stimulation involves cutting a small hole in the skull and placing an electrode, well, deep into the brain. The device works well as a treatment for diseases like depression and Parkinson's. In fact, about 100,000 people use deep brain stimulation, according to the makers of one such device. The military is particularly interested in using it to treat PTSD and other disorders. In studies in mice with a type of PTSD, DBS worked better than current treatment methods like selective serotonin uptake inhibitors. The device could work well in a military setting by changing the neural activity in the amygdala. The amygdala plays a role in processing emotions and reactions like fear. So deep brain stimulation could dampen activity in that part of the brain when a soldier experiences a traumatic event. Basically, it lessens the emotion associated with that memory. So yeah, super scienced up soldiers who experience no fear? That's not scary at all. So there's clearly a lot of ethical issues surrounding these kind of technologies. While therapeutic for some, in the wrong hands, it could change the game for what it means to be human. But for now, if you want to improve your focus or boost your creativity, either hit the gym or drink some coffee to give you an edge. Speaking of getting an edge in the workplace, a great website is a good place to start. No domain extension will help you tell your story like a .com or .net domain name. And because you watch DNews, you can get 15% off domain.com's names and web hosting by using the code DNews when you check out. And speaking of intelligence, is the IQ test all it's cracked up to be? Lacey takes a deeper look at what having a high IQ really means in this video here.
A Canadian study published in the journal Neuron examined over 100,000 people from across the world and found that the almighty IQ test is fundamentally flawed.
So what do you think? Would you ever put on this kind of thinking cap? Let us know down in the comments below. While you're there, don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons and keep coming back here. We've got new episodes every day of the week.